8:53, we continue our Black History Month reports at the Plymouth Church in Brooklyn Heights, a church that housed one of the busiest stops on the Underground Railroad, the network of secret routes and safe havens for slaves seeking freedom, the route that helped thousands escape to the North in the 1800s. Beneath the pews of the church was once the Grand Central of the Underground Railroad. Roger Clark joins us now with more on this. Hi, Roger.
Yeah, Pat, you got it. That's exactly what they called it, the Grand Central Depot. We call it terminal. Some people call it station. We know that it's actually a terminal, but that's a whole other story. But this was a major stop. Now, this church founded in 1847, but this particular building built in 1849 by the great abolitionist Henry Ward Beecher. And this is a guy who, if you see the church here, but we visited the basement, you go downstairs, and that is where slaves were brought from the South. Along the way, there stops. Now, they would start sometimes in lower Manhattan and would take a boat across the East River because it was not safe for them across the river in Manhattan. Bringing them here to Brooklyn, and then they would make their way up north to places like Boston, even as far up as Canada as well. Okay, so you think that's enough history for this place in Brooklyn Heights? No, there's more. Martin Luther King Jr., you know, he would visit many, many churches during his time, during the Civil Rights era. And this is one of the places. He did a speech that was very familiar. It was the dream speech from the March on Washington. And in fact, not only did he did it here, and then when he started doing his famous speech in D.C., he actually wasn't going to do this speech, but Mahalia Jackson, the great gospel singer, said, do the dream speech, do the dream speech. True story. And the rest is history. Who else was here? Yes, President Abraham Lincoln, also, of course, tied to civil rights and anti-slavery. He sat in this pew. You see this picture? He actually was here twice. He was downstairs. He had the good seats, and he was also up here in the balcony because he wanted to remain anonymous. Abraham Lincoln trying to remain anonymous. Go figure. Finally, even more. Ready? Jackie Robinson, who broke the color barrier in Major League Baseball, guys. Branch Rickey, the general manager of the Brooklyn Dodgers, before he made that decision, he was friends with the pastor here. He prayed in the office here at the church for an hour and then decided that he would sign Jackie Robinson to a contract. And again, the rest is history, baseball history, and civil rights history. Unbelievable stuff here, guys. All you have to do is pop by. They do tours every Sunday at 12:30.
Thank you, Roger. It's 8:56.